Welcome back to our second segment. Our guest is Eliott Rodriguez from CBS4, the man of CBS4, and I encourage you to watch him as well on air because he's doing such a wonderful job for a very long time in South Florida, and we love him here in South Florida. Eliott, now let's talk about anything else. You've been to Cuba?
I have.
And you've seen some of your parents, some of your family members in Cuba. Tell me about your experience when you went to Cuba. How did you feel?
Well, people always ask me, well, what stories impacted you and what story do you remember? And for me, it has to be when I went to Cuba. As I mentioned to you, I was not born in Cuba. I was born in New York City, but I grew up in a very Cuban household. My parents came from Cuba. They spoke Spanish and they raised us in a very Cuban way. So I always had that very deep love, you know, for the country. I'd never been. So for me, going to Cuba the first time, I was working for another TV station. I'll mention them, Channel 10.
Of course.
I was working for
That's
Channel 10.
So many 10. Years there, right?
I was there for a while. And I did get the opportunity to go to Cuba. And then after that, I went more and more. And I got to meet my family. And what was interesting to me was I always thought that I came from a small family because it was my mom, my dad, my sister, and me. But really, I come from a big family. My father had six brothers and sisters who stayed back in their town, Regla, in Cuba. It's a little, you take a little lanchita, a little boat, and you get over there. And when I got there, I met all these relatives that I didn't know. So for me, it was reconnecting with who I am and my family. So really, the story, when people say what story impacted you the most, it had to be visiting Cuba.
Now there are changes in policies. Will you encourage any Cuban American to visit Cuba?
I do, absolutely, without any doubt. You know why? Because there's no substitute for seeing something with your own eyes. People can tell you, oh, how horrible it is and how this and that, everything about it. But there's no substitute for seeing something with your own eyes, talking to people, listening to their story, and making up your own mind. So absolutely, yes.
We know there are so many political side on when it comes to Cuba and cultural aspect. What is your point of view when it comes to Cuba now? What would you tell our viewers about
Cuba? My point of view has always been very open, and I've always felt that the U.S. policy toward Cuba has been a failure when we tried to isolate Cuba for so many years. And I was very hopeful when former President Obama opened up Cuba for people to travel there, because I, as a Cuban American, decided a long time ago that my disdain for Fidel Castro, my dislike for Fidel and Raul, was not going to keep me from visiting my family. I was not going to be separated from them. I want to see them. I want to help them. And it's not going to keep me from this country that is so important to me. I'm an American, but this is important to me. So I've always felt that way. Now we see that we're going kind of back to the Cold War. And we'll have to see how it all plays out.
Let me take you back to South Florida now, a community you've seen involved in so many ways. What do you think of the community of South Florida, you know, in comparison to, like, it's a mosaic of culture. You meet everybody here in South Florida.
I love it here. This is home for me, and I feel very comfortable here. Miami, as you well know, is an international city, the capital of the Caribbean and Latin America. Sometimes when you travel from one place in Latin America to another, you have to come through Miami, right?
Yes.
So I love it here, and I love the weather. I love the ocean. I love the people. I love the diversity. I like listening to many languages. It doesn't bother me. I like seeing different cultures. It to me, it's part of the beauty of Miami. I can understand some people may be uncomfortable with it, but for me, it's wonderful, and I wouldn't want to live anywhere else.
How involved you are in the Cuban community of South Florida, besides croqueta and coladita?
No, I'm involved in the Cuban community of my family, the Rodriguez family. I'm not really involved in any organizations or anything. I do encourage my children to be in touch with their roots, and they have. And I was very proud of the fact that they were able to go to visit Cuba.
Wow, great. Let's talk about your biggest accomplishment. What would that be?
Oh, my biggest accomplishment, without a doubt, is my family, my daughters. I have four daughters, and that's by far my biggest accomplishment. Very proud of them.
Wow. Somebody somehow saying me, somebody, hey, need to wear like the glasses, you know, getting jealous of some four daughters.
Yes, four girls.
Wow. Great. And how to tell me a little bit more about them.
Well, my oldest daughter is a professor. She has a PhD. She teaches at the University of Central Florida. My second oldest daughter, Bianca, is a teacher, second grade teacher in Miami. and she's wonderful. Her kids love her. She has the perfect personality for being a teacher. And then I have a daughter who is a student at American University, Julia. She's graduating now in December. And my youngest, my baby, is at NYU, at New York University. So she's a New Yorker.
Wow.
Yeah, so that gives me an excuse to go back to New York.
Absolutely. Stay with us, Eliott. We're going to take a last break. But when we come back, we'll talk about passion, faith, strength, and struggles. We'll be right back.